2006 through 2011 Toyota Camry with a 2.4 liter engine, serpentine belt replacement. I'm Brian Esser from How To Automotive. I'm going to walk you through the steps of replacing the serpentine belt. So we're going to get started replacing the serpentine belt. Before I get started, I wanted to show you this little diagram that I printed out. This diagram is courtesy of All Data. It's on how the belt is routed. And it also, if you look, it says use a 19 millimeter wrench or socket right here at the top of the tensioner and rotate it clockwise. But I have found that doing it the way the factory recommends it, it's a little on the difficult side. So I'm going to show you an alternative way. First thing you need to do is get your vehicle, at least the front of the vehicle, up in the air and remove the right front wheel. If you're doing this at home, use floor jacks and jack stands. And also you want the suspension hanging down. We're going to remove this inner splash shield here. It's held on with a couple 10 millimeter bolts here. So you're going to remove these two bolts. And to make quick work of that, I'm going to use my Milwaukee M18 fuel. It's a 3/8 drive, a little impact gun here. And then after we get these two bolts removed, at the very bottom of the panel, we need to remove another a third 10 millimeter bolt because there's a clip behind it we need to get to. So you're going to remove the 10 millimeter bolt right here. And then you're going to peel the panel down and then peel the upper panel back a little bit. And then you can get to the third clip right there. So you'll pop that clip off and then the panel will come off. Now, as you look right here, you can see the tensioner, and there's a 14 millimeter bolt on the pulley on the tensioner. So I'm going to use a ratcheting wrench. This wrench I'm using is about 18 inches long. It's made by Mountain. It's great for using it on serpentine belts. I will link it up in the description of the video. So we're going to place the wrench onto the tensioner pulley here where it has a 14 millimeter bolt. We're going to set the wrench where it's going clockwise, then we'll spring it over, and then we'll reach up and we'll pull it off one of the pulleys. I found slipping it off the water pump was the easiest. It's the easiest to get your hand up there. Once you got the belt pulled off of one of the pulleys, you can go ahead and remove the tool, and then you can go ahead and look up inside and just look how everything's routed. And after you kind of got a good idea, then you can start unrouting the belt and taking the belt out of the car. So you'll just peel it out, and you may have to twist the belt to get it between some of the pulleys here, like the AC compressor here. So once you get the belt out, you want to replace it with a quality belt. I recommend Gates belts. This is the part number for it. I will link it up in the description of the video. So you're going to take the belt like this and loop, make it create a loop and feed it up. And you want to put it on the alternator pulley first. So you may have to go up top and put it on. Then you can start routing it according to the diagram that I printed out. So I positioned it around the alternator, went around the idler pulley, and then around the compressor. And now I run it back down towards the power steering pump. And once it goes around the power steering pump, you pull it back up and over the tensioner portion of it. If you look right here, you can also see where the factory wants you to put your 19 millimeter socket to torque the tensioner over, but it's difficult to get to. So I went back underneath, and now I'm going to tension the tensioner back out of my way. So I positioned the wrench back onto the tensioner pulley and torqued it over and then slipped the belt over the crank pulley here. Or if it's difficult, you can put it on any one of the pulleys that you feel comfortable. After you're done, you're just going to double check and make sure everything is routed correctly and in all the grooves. Then you can take the plastic shield here and reposition that back on and start the 10 millimeter bolt and the little clip that's on the inside. And then once you get those all secure, then you can resecure the bottom splash shield here. And then after that, you can go ahead and install the tires. And we're going to torque these tires down to 76 foot-pounds. Once you got the tires torqued, that'll complete the job of replacing the serpentine belt on a 2006 through 2011 Toyota Camry with the 2.4 engine. I will link up all the parts and tools in the description of the video. I'd like to thank you guys for watching my videos. Encourage you to subscribe. Invite you to head over to the howtoautomotive.com website for more valuable videos like this. And I'd like to remind you that when it comes to working on cars, experience is everything. I'm Brian Esser from How To Automotive, and I'd like to thank you again for watching.